Hi, my name is Dr. Devaruti Kaldar, and in this lecture session, I'm going to discuss about Nyay Panchayat. Let us first understand what is Nyay Panchayat. India has a rich history of justice administration. If we see from the contemporary understanding about justice administration, we would see that at the top of the hierarchy of the courts, there is Supreme Court, that is the highest appellate court of the country. Next is the High Court for the states. Below this are the sessions courts and the district courts and the taluka courts. At the grassroots level is the village panchayat system or the Gram Nyayalay. The unique features of Nyay Panchayat may include these understandings. Nyay Panchayat is a village level justice delivery body. It basically handles the resolution, that is the dispute resolution, in the presence of five elected representatives who are known as panchas, that means the panch. Nyay Panchayat, as we just discussed, is a very ancient system of justice delivery system. Therefore, in Nyay Panchayat system, there is no presence of lawyers. Basically, Nyay Panchayat follows the ADR mechanism for dispute resolution. Mediation may not follow legal process in cases of Nyay Panchayat dispute resolution process. Nyay Panchayat, being a village level panchayat or justice administration system, may only try petty cases. Nyay Panchayats are basically equal to what is known as justices of peaces in some of the Western countries. That means at the very grassroots level of the justice administration system. The sanctions and punishments that are used by the Nyay Panchayat basically include social boycotting system, fines, it can be pecuniary fines, and certain ancient restorative justice system, for example, return of the stolen item to the victim. However, the justice delivery system of the Nyay Panchayat may have advantages as well as disadvantages. The advantages include speedy justice system, because this does not follow the legal procedure, this does not include the presence of the lawyers, and it is completely based on the mediation procedure, which need not follow the strict legal procedure. But on the other hand, the disadvantages may include baseless, corruptive justice delivery system, because the Nyay Panchayat is not headed by the trained judges or even the lawyers. The Nyay Panchayat system was modernized with the introduction of Panchayat Raj Act 1947. According to this statute, the state government or the prescribed authority shall divide a district into different circles. Each circle shall have, subject to the jurisdiction, as many Gram Panchayats as possible, and every Gram Panchayat may have a Nyay Panchayat. Every circle should have one Nyay Panchayat, and these circles, that is the Nyay Panchayats, will be contiguous with each other. That means they should be connected with each other. Now the question comes as how many members should be there in the Nyay Panchayat. This statute says that there can be minimum of 10 and maximum of 25 members in a Nyay Panchayat. Section 43 of this Panchayat Raj Act speaks about appointment of panchas and their term. Basically, the members of the Gram Panchayat can be elected as the members of the Nyay Panchayat. Section 43 therefore says, there shall be appointed by the prescribed authority out of the members of a Gram Panchayat such number of persons as may be prescribed to the panchas of the Nyay Panchayat, and thereupon the members of the appointed Nyay Panchayat shall cease to be the members of the Gram Panchayat. It also says that if the requisite number of the members of a Gram Panchayat are not available for being the panchas of the Nyay Panchayat, it shall be lawful for the prescribed authority to fill in any seat so remaining vacant by nomination from amongst the other members of the Gram Panchayat. Further, it also says that no person may be appointed as the panch of the Nyay Panchayat unless he has the prescribed qualification that may be prescribed by the proper regulations and also by proper authorities. However, where suitable persons having the prescribed qualifications are not available, then any or all of such qualifications may by order in writing be relaxed for getting members from the Gram Panchayat to be the members of the Nyay Panchayat. Section 44 speaks about election of Sarpanchayat, Sarpanch and Sahayak Sarpanch for the record keeping. So the Panchas basically would have one Sarpanch who should be considered as the chief of the Panchas, and he should have a Sahayak Sarpanch for record keeping. Coming to the question of term of Nyay Panchayat, the statute also indicates that every panch of a Nyay Panchayat shall commence on the date of his appointment, and unless otherwise determined under the provisions of this act, the term shall expire with the Gram Panchayat from which he was appointed. That means his term would be basically starting with the appointment with the Nyay Panchayat, and basically it will finish with his expiry of the term in the Gram Panchayat. Further, it is also stated that Sarpanch and the Sahayak Sarpanch shall continue in office until their respective successors are elected or appointed, which means that the office of Nyay Panchayat shall not go vacant just because their terms have ended, which also indicates that until and unless their successors are elected or appointed, the same Sarpanch or the Sahayak and the Sahayak Sarpanch shall continue in their office. Now, we will discuss about the bench of Nyay Panchayat and their limitations. It is the Sarpanch who can form the benches consisting of 5 panchas, each for the disposal of the cases and inquiries that are coming up before the Nyay Panchayat. The formation of the bench, period for which they will work, including the hearing of part heard cases, etc., the method of distribution of the cases, transfer, retransfer of the work among the benches, and the procedure that is generally to be followed by them in cases and inquiries shall be governed by the rules made by the appropriate authorities or also by the state government. However, there is a limitation as per this statute which prohibits Panch, Sarpanch or Sahayak Panch to take part in any trial, inquiry or in any case to which he or any of his relation, his employer, employee or his debtor, creditor, partner, etc. are or is a party, or in which any of this, that is any of the members of this bench, may be personally interested. Further, the state government may prescribe the constitution of special benches for the trial of any class or classes of cases. The state government may also order for reconstitution of such benches. If there becomes or if there arises any dispute relating to the formation of the benches or the method of their working, etc., it shall be referred to the prescribed authority, and the decision of such prescribed authority shall be final. Now, we will speak about the jurisdiction of the Nyay Panchayat to handle the cases. This is little different than the general prescribed method of the criminal procedure courts, which generally is taken over by the regular courts. The statute says that every criminal case triable by a Nyay Panchayat shall be instituted before the sarpanch of the Nyay Panchayat of the circle where the offence is committed. Generally, we do get to see that as per the criminal procedure code, a victim may lodge a complaint where the victim is presently situated, or where the victim has basically been victimized, or in such cases where the passerby, or for example the relative, or for example the friends of the victim, etc., they have rescued the victim or they have seen the victimization. In such cases, the complainant can go to the police and lodge the complaint. But in this case, as we get to see, that the Nyay Panchayat will be having the jurisdiction to try the criminal cases, and this jurisdiction basically falls only in the circle where the offence has been committed. The same goes for the civil cases also, and we get to see that every civil case shall be instituted before the sarpanch of the Nyay Panchayat of the circle where the defendant, or where there are more than one defendants. Generally, all the defendants reside or carry on the business at the time of the institution of the civil case. Let us now understand about the offences that are cognizable by the Nyay Panchayat. Generally, Nyay Panchayat can handle petty offences. For example, Section 140, Section 160, 172, 174, 179, 269, 283, 290, 294, 324, 357, 358, 403, 411 of the Indian Penal Code, where the value of the stolen property or the misappropriate property, in cases especially for theft, etc., or where the punishment, etc., is very less. For example, especially in cases of 379, 403, etc., where the value of the stolen property does not exceed 50 rupees. Further, it can also deal with cases, for example, under Section 430, 447, 504, 509, etc. However, with the amendment of the criminal law, we have seen that there are certain offences which have now enhanced punishment. That means, for example, 509 of the Indian Penal Code, the punishment has been enhanced from merely 6 months' time to minimum 1 year time. So in such cases, they may not be given to the Nyay Panchayat. Again, offences under Sections 24 and 26 of the Cattle Trespass Act 1871, especially in such cases where the punishment is petty punishment or the amount of pecuniary fine, etc., is not very heavy. Offences under Subsection 1 of 10 of the United Provinces District Board Primary Education Act 1926, offences under Section 3, 4, 7 and 13 of the Public Gambling Act 1867, etc., can also be handled by Nyay Panchayat. Any other offence under the aforesaid enactments, or any other enactment as may be, by notification in the Official Gazette, be declared by the state government to be cognizable by a Nyay Panchayat, and such offences may also be taken down from this list. further any offence under this particular act or under any rule made thereunder may also be given to the Nyayik Panchayat. However, it also depends upon the courts to provide or transfer certain cases for Nyayik Panchayat in case the court may feel that Nyayik Panchayat is the correct forum to deal with such cases. After the Nyayik Panchayat has been established for any area, no court, except as otherwise provided by this statute, shall take cognizance of any case which may be tried by Nyayik Panchayat. However, when a Nyayik Panchayat is suspended or superseded or dissolved, or for any other reason it ceases to function, all cases pending before it shall stand transferred to the court of a competent jurisdiction. The trial of all such cases shall commence de novo, that means it should start afresh. Nyayik Panchayat shall not be deemed to be ceasing the function merely for the reason that the panches have to be re-elected. Now the question comes as when the courts can transfer cases to Nyayik Panchayat and when the Nyayik Panchayat can vice versa transfer the cases to the courts. Section 56 basically discusses about this and says that a court, if it finds that a case is triable by a Nyayik Panchayat, shall transfer the case to the same Nyayik Panchayat of competent jurisdiction, and the said Nyayik Panchayat shall try the case after the transfer de novo. A Nyayik Panchayat may also dismiss any complaint if, after examining the complaint and the evidences, it is satisfied that the complaint is frivolous, vexatious or untrue. In this way, the Nyayik Panchayat can also control defamatory complaints or misleading complaints or false complaints. Now the question comes as when should the Nyayik Panchayat transfer the cases to the courts? There are few points that we must note to understand when this can happen. Nyayik Panchayat can transfer the cases to the courts when it has no jurisdiction to try the cases that are pending before it. That means the Nyayik Panchayat is basically not eligible to try such cases. Nyayik Panchayat may also transfer the cases to the courts when the offence involved is one for which it cannot award adequate punishment. That means the punishment is heavier than what Nyayik Panchayat can basically prescribe or can basically give to the offender. In cases which is triable by a court, parties to be given information that such kinds of cases may be taken to the court, especially when the Nyayik Panchayat finds out that these are the points because of which the case may not be handled by the Nyayik Panchayat. Now, we will discuss about the sarpanch duty for peacekeeping, which comes within the meaning of functioning of the Nyayik Panchayat. Sarpanch under Section 53 of the Panchayat Act may perform certain duties of a police officer, and this includes issuing a show cause notice to any person whom he apprehends that he is likely to commit a breach of peace or disturb the public tranquility, etc. The show cause notice is issued basically to show cause how he should not execute or why he should not execute a bond or an amount not exceeding rupees 100 with or without sureties for keeping the peace for a period not exceeding 15 days. As you can understand from here, this show cause notice basically carries a very puny amount, but still then the importance of issuing the show cause notice has been given to the sarpanch. However, this power of issuing show cause notice cannot be an arbitrary power. The sarpanch shall, after the issuance of such notice, report the matter to the bench. The bench may either confirm the order or discharge the notice after hearing such person and such witnesses as this person may desire to produce. However, if the person is required to execute a bond as aforesaid and he fails to do so, he shall be liable to pay a penalty, as which is according to the Panchayat Raj Act is up to 5 rupees, as the bench may fix for every day if the default continues during the period fixed in the order. The question which most of us may be curious to know is, who may not be tried by the Nyay Panchayat? That is, who may not be tried? Section 59 of the Panchayat Raj Act has the answer. It says, no Nyay Panchayat shall take cognizance of any criminal case against a person where such person has been previously convicted of an offence punishable with imprisonment of either description for a term of 3 years or more. Most of the times we do get to see that if a person is punished or if a person is sentenced for punishment which goes for 3 years or more, it might become a cognizable offence. So in that cases, such persons are not triable by a Nyay Panchayat. Nyay Panchayat may also not take cognizance of a criminal case where against that person previous fine for theft etc. has been basically prescribed by the Nyay Panchayat. That means it is a repeated offence. Further, no Nyay Panchayat shall take cognizance of any criminal case against a person where such person has been found over to be of a good behavior under section 109 or under section 110 of the Code of Criminal Procedure Code 1973. Nyay Panchayat shall also not take cognizance of any criminal case against a person where this person has been previously convicted under the Public Gambling Act. The previous clause and this clause basically attracts the attention of the Criminal Procedure Code and also another statute that is Public Gambling Act, and therefore Nyay Panchayat shall not have any scope in these two cases. Finally, Nyay Panchayat shall not take cognizance of any criminal case against a person who is a public servant. The question which now we are going to discuss is, what sort of penalties may be prescribed by Nyay Panchayat? We have seen in the earlier slides that Nyay Panchayat shall not prescribe any heavy punishment. Then what sort of penalties? Because we have seen that Nyay Panchayat is a very much traditional village court, and therefore they might prescribe some kinds of penalties, punishment, etc., whereby it can be return of the stolen goods or, for example, social boycotting, etc. But here we are going to understand what does the statute, that is the Panchayat Raj Act, basically prescribe for a Nyay Panchayat for prescribing some penalties. Section 54 deals with it, and it says, no Nyay Panchayat shall inflict a substantive sentence of imprisonment. That means Nyay Panchayat cannot prescribe any punishment for imprisonment. This is exclusively done by the courts after a proper investigation by the police. Next, a Nyay Panchayat may impose a fine not exceeding 250 rupees, but not imprisonment, may be awarded in default of payment, which means that the Nyay Panchayat can basically prescribe for fine, and that fine may go for up to 250 rupees or, as per the present understanding, up to a certain amount. But at the same time, Nyay Panchayat shall not have any scope to basically prescribe for imprisonment for default in payment of the fine. Again, that can be done by the judicial magistrate. No accused shall be tried for more than 3 offences in the same criminal case, and the fine that may be imposed on any one accused in a criminal case shall not in the aggregate exceed 250 rupees. Basically, Nyay Panchayat is a village court, and the village court cannot have much power when it comes to prescribing of the penalties and punishment. Hence, the Panchayat Raj Act has basically narrowed down the scope of Nyay Panchayat in prescribing penalties and also punishment. Does Nyay Panchayat have any power for restitution of justice for the accused person? Section 61 of the Panchayat Raj Act speaks about this particular provision. It says, or it speaks about compensation to the accused. It says, if in any criminal case instituted before a Nyay Panchayat, any person who is accused of any offence that can be triable by the Nyay Panchayat is acquitted by the Nyay Panchayat on the ground that the complaint that was filed against him was false, frivolous or vexatious, the Nyay Panchayat may call upon the complainant to show cause why he should not pay compensation to such accused. And thereafter, the Nyay Panchayat can go ahead for directing the complainant to pay a sum to the particular accused person. This compensation can be fixed according to the present economic condition, etc., of the accused person. But it may never be exceeding a particular amount that only the judicial magistrates or the courts can prescribe. We will now discuss about the scope of Nyay Panchayat to try civil law cases. A Nyay Panchayat may take cognizance of any civil case of the following description if its value does not exceed 100 rupees. And these cases may include a civil case for money due on contract other than a contract in respect of immovable property, a civil case for the recovery of movable property or for the value thereof, a civil case for compensation for wrongfully taking or injuring a movable property, a civil case for damages caused by cattle trespass. As we just now understood what sort of civil cases may be taken over by the Nyay Panchayat, there are cases, that is civil cases, which are ineligible for Nyay Panchayat. These include a civil case for a balance due on partnership account except where the balance has been struck by the parties or their agents. A civil case for a share or part of share under an intestacy or for a legacy or part of a legacy under a will. A civil case by or against the state government or the central government or a public servant for acts done in his official capacity. A civil case by or against a minor or a person of unsound mind. And as the Panchayat Raj Act prescribes, a civil case the cognizance of which by a panchayat established under the UP Village Panchayat Act 1920 is barred by Section 25 of the United Provinces Debt Redemption Act 1940. These are the civil cases which are ineligible for Nyay Panchayat. Now we are going to discuss about the effect of the decision of the Nyay Panchayat. We have discussed that Nyay Panchayat has got very limited scope, especially for trial of cases. It can actually handle very petty matters. The discussion on the effect of the decision of the Nyay Panchayat are carried on in two specific sections, that is Section 69 and 79 of the Panchayat Raj Act. Section 69 says that the decision of the Nyay Panchayat on the question of the title, legal character of the contract or obligation shall not bind the parties except in respect of the civil case in which such matter is decided, which means that the Nyay Panchayat has got very limited scope for creating a precedence, which we generally see in cases of judicial magistrates courts or in cases of high courts or supreme courts. Further, no conviction ordered by a Nyay Panchayat shall by itself operate as or be the basis of any disqualification or penalty under any law for the time being in force. which means that Nyay Panchayat basically has got a very limited power for prescribing some heavy punishment, which might go for influencing the disqualification, etc., of a particular person who has been charged with an offence. Section 79 also discusses about the power to revise or review the decisions of the Nyay Panchayat. It says, Nyay Panchayat not to revise or review its decision unless this is done to correct a clerical error. Further, a Nyay Panchayat for sufficient reasons to be recorded on applications made within 1 month of the date of the decree or order or knowledge thereof in case the personal service of the summons has not been effected may restore a civil or criminal case which has been dismissed in default or in which a decree or order has been passed ex parte. Basically, in this case, what we get to understand is that Nyay Panchayat must be very much vigilant about safeguarding the rights of both the sides, both the parties. And that is the reason we do get to see that the decision of the Nyay Panchayat may not be revised or reviewed until and unless there is a proper notice, there is a proper application has been made and the judgment has been passed either on default or it has actually been passed on ex parte, and the Nyay Panchayat cannot basically jeopardize the rights of the other party. Thank you.